Zombie apocalypse.
Okay, good afternoon class again. This is Sir Kenji. You can call me Dr. Kenji, but I prefer to use Sir Kenji na lang po o Sir Kench. I am Sir Kenji Imerenciano. Whether you like it or not, I'll be your course facilitator and you will stay with me throughout the SEM as your course facilitator in Educ 9. Educ 9 is the technology for teaching and learning too. Okay, this is a continuation or a prerequisite which is the Educ 5, Technology for Teaching and Learning 1. May I ask, who was your subject professor or course facilitator last SEM in TTL 1? May I know?
Don Raymond, sir.
Yes, Don Raymond. Scarpe?
Si Sir Don Raymond po, sir.
Ah, Bermundo. Sir Bermundo. So, may I know what are the topics you encountered or you learned sa TTL 1 so we can have adjustment or revisions pagdating sa Educ 9 or TTL 2? Anyone? Can you still recall? What are the topics or lessons that Sir Don Bermundo teach or taught you? Anyone? So your silence signifies that you didn't learn anything. Yeah, okay. Yes, Miss Listanko.
So yung natandaan ko lang po, sir, specifically po, sir, is yung mga parang website, sir, or apps na nakakatulong po, sir, sa pagturo and as well as po, sir, sa amin ng mga student, like Google Classroom po, sir, Canva, yun po, sir.
Okay, thank
yun
you.
Yun po yung particular na.
So, what you've learned from Sir Bermundo is about the what we call the technology or educational technology tools, okay, that helps or assists you in the teaching-learning process or presenting a topic, understanding the lesson, like for example what Ms. Listanko said, yung Google Classroom, yung Canva, kasi commonly ginagamit ng mga faculty or mga traditional teachers is yung PowerPoint. Diba? PowerPoint is a brand. Okay, it's a brand of Microsoft, but that's part of the Microsoft Office Suite, but it's a presentation software. A Canva is kagaya din ng PowerPoint, ginagamit din sa presentation. So what else? Aside from the educational apps or programs, what else did you learn sa TTL 1? Yes? Mr. Gabay, can you please turn on your camera para makilala kita? Anything you've learned last SEM?
Yung naalala ko lang, sir, is yung topic na roles of of technology for educators.
Okay, sige. So, as we know, thank you, Mr. Gabriel. As we know, technology plays a significant role in the educational system and the teaching learning process. Okay, it's a tool that will help you to appreciate a topic, a tool that will assist you in the delivery of instruction. And not only that, we also learn about basically sa TTL 1 kasi si Sir Kenji po, si Sir Nindo, nagturo din po ako ng TTL 1. So, the highlights of the topics or the presentation or the course outline last time are the following. First is the introduction to technology for teaching and learning. Okay. So, what is meant by technology? Sa context ninyo, ano ba ibig sabihin ng technology sa teaching and learning? Diba? Pag sinabing technology, these are a product of a research. When you say technology, that is it's an applied process. Diba? Or meaning to say, it is applied science. So, what you've learned, mbawa, we know about how about look, magpapaka-technical ako ng konti, we learn about nuclear fusion and fission, sa physics, right? It's rather the splitting of hydrogen and something like that, or elements. And because of that discovery, na-develop yung atomic bomb. Okay? So, when is yung technology is atomic bomb, eh. But the science behind it, or the reason behind, is yung the nuclear fission and fusion concept. So parang sa technology, diba? Before, by the way, ano mga major pala ninyo dito sa section na to? Mr. Abrantes, ano yung mga major niyo dito sa BTBTED? Naka-opo yung audio mo?
Ngayong ano po, sir, yung ngayong SEM.
Even last SEM pa, anong major ninyo?
Ano sir, sa electrical po, may electrical. Ano ka?
Sige. Po. Is this purely electrical lang ba? Or may iba pang major dito? Correct me if I'm wrong, ha? Vlad, ba kayo dito BTBTED major in electrical, or are there any other course or major pala, I should say? Please respond po.
Lahat lang po, sir.
Ah, so lahat. So meaning to say, Mr. Abrantes, lahat kayo dito electrical technology yung major?
Yes po.
Okay, thank you. Yun lang po. So meaning to say, lahat kayo dito electrical technology. Right? Halimbawa, if we're going to differentiate, di ba? To fully understand technology. Benjamin Franklin, kasi I teach also fundamentals of electricity. By the way, si Sir Kenji pala, I'm an affiliated faculty in BTBTED department. But actually, ang aking department is electronics technology. So yung BTBTED, yung tinuturo ko sa inyo is I'm just an affiliate. Aside from the BTBTED department, affiliated din po ako sa MEIE. MEIE stands for Master of Arts in Industrial Education. So si Sir Kenji po is nagtuturo din ng masteral subjects. Okay? Sa context ng electrical, ako po ay nagtuturo ng electronics technology. Ang mga hawak ko pong subject ay mostly research. That's my favorite subject. And yung iba is workshop. And then, nagtuturo din ako ng fundamentals of electricity and electronics probably mga 5 or 7 years ago. So, I told to my students na ang na, for example, electricity was discovered also by one of the scientists, like in the name of Benjamin Franklin, based on his experiment na of a kite. Diba? You can still remember. Merong saranggola, nilagyan niya ng susi. And accidentally, he discovered that it was struck by a lightning. And out of it was found out na ang metal is a good conductor of electricity. So, marami. Sanga-sanga na yung kwento. So, because of the discovery of electricity, meron tayong tinatawag na conductors, di ba? Conductors and insulators. When you say conductors, these are materials that has the capacity to absorb, conducts or accepts electricity. While insulators, sila yung, di ba, counter ng conductor. So, ganun. So, because of the discoveries, may nabuong technology. Because of electricity, meron tayong tinatawag na electric fan, aircon, television, computer, parang ganun. Okay. But in the context of education, technology plays also an essential role. Diba? Kagaya ngayon, we are in the midst of pandemic, right? We are up to now, hindi pa lifted yung ating, I'm praying and hoping that everything goes to normal. Sana magkaroon na ng face-to-face classes. And based on what I've heard, may mga subjects daw dito sa inyo na allow na po yung limited face-to-face. Tama po ba? May subject na ba kayo na parang i-integrate na po yung I think yung in-approve ata is may kinalaman sa laboratory. May subject na po ba kayo dito na allowed na kayo mag face-to-face? Are you prepared?
Meron na po, sir.
Yes, Ms. Distanco.
Meron po, sir.
May I know? Anong subject po?
Meron po, sir, yung sa kay Sir Buen. Allowed na po yun, sir. Pero hinahantay na lang daw po, sir, na i-pursue talaga, sir. Allowed po yung sa subject, sir. Hinahantay na lang daw po ata yung palang okay. Ano, permission to conduct.
Okay. Thank you, Ms. Listango. Kasi, actually, class, it's really hard. I know what you're coming from. Like now, based on my record, 26 are enrolled in this course. By the way, let's set things clear. When I say course, this pertains to your subject. Okay, what I mean subject is the Educ 9 Technology for Teaching and Learning 2. Baka magkaroon tayo ng disparity or confusion. Okay? But when I say course, this pertains to your subject. Okay? So, yeah. I know most of us are struggling, not only the students, even the faculty. It's really hard for us to prepare the lessons and materials and conduct synchronous meetings when sometimes our internet providers, di ba? Sometimes we experience technical difficulty or errors with regards to our internet. Okay. Kumbaga, sana all merong malakas na internet connection. Sana all laging may unlimited yung supply ng data. Sana all yung area nila malapit sa, di ba, sa mga satellite or stations. So, that's why, baga, if you can still remember, please bear with me, ano, if we weren't able to meet this past several weeks. Sir Kenji is really busy. Akala kasi ng mga students, we faculty perform only instructions. Well, in fact, we have so many tasks to perform. I'm not complaining. That is part of our job. Aside from performing instruction or giving you lessons, we also perform other clerical tasks. We also have assignments or designations. But it's not an excuse for us to be here to conduct lessons, to impart your knowledge or wisdom, to better appreciate the subjects. It's not an excuse. Okay, please. Ang akin lang is konting pasensya lang because actually, I'm not sure. Probably by March, magiging busy na naman si Sir Kenji because of the upcoming accreditation. So, si Sir is actively involved in the preparation of BTBTED or MEI Level 4 for the accreditation. So, I think you are aware naman, you understand naman siguro if a faculty or if the university or college undergoes accreditation. Ang results nito or ang feedback nito is para din sa mga students because you are our clients. Okay? So, limited lang yung time natin. What I'm going to do now is to present to you the course, the content of our course syllabus. So, I have to share this with you. And, sige. Itab. Just let me know if you can see what's on the screen. Okay. Nakikita po ba, class?
Yes, sir.
So, do you have to zoom in para mabasa?
Yes, po, sir.
Okay, thank you for confirming. So, ito po yung ating course syllabus. We know that a course syllabus or, is your reference or guide on about the course, di ba? The Educ 9 Technology for Teaching and Learning 2. Our term is second sem. And not only the name of or the title of the course, but also who will be in charge by this sem. This sem, kami po ni Sir Chan, Sir Christian C. Calleja, our department chair, and together with the program advisor in Drafting Technology. And me also, I'm also a program advisor in the Electronics Technology Department. Kami pong tatlo will be the faculty for this course. Okay? So, I'll skip na lang because you've seen already or what is our institutional learning outcomes, the 8 program learning outcomes. So, this will be your future career or path once you finish the BTBTED course or program. So, what is TTL2 and how does it differ sa Educ 5 or the TTL1. Actually, to simplify po, ang TTL1 is more about principles. It's more about theories. Theories on how how technology is being used to improve instruction, to improve the classroom management, the strategies, so that the students can easily grasp or understand the topics in a subject. Kumbaga, it's an introductory about the background, about different types of technology and models on the proper use of these tools. Kagaya ng sinabi ni Mr. Gabay kanina, na pag natutunan niya kung anong role ng technology sa teaching-learning process. Yan, pinag-aralan natin ninyo doon. The safety issues and practices na dapat gamitin. Diba? And natutunan ninyo kung anong mga programs, applications, software na magandang gamitin sa pagtuturo. So, kumbaga, it's more an introduction. But in the case of technology for teaching and learning too, your theory that you acquired from TTL1 will be put into practice. Meaning to say, application. Now, based on the course description, this will focus on the application, design, production, utilization, and evaluation of ICT, which simply stands for Information and Communication Technology Materials for Teaching and Learning in a Particular Subject Specialization. Kaya nga, tinanong ko kayo kanina, BTBTED kayo, second year, ano ba yung major na tinuturuan ninyo? Good thing you've said that your focus is on electrical technology. So, this course class is more of a problem-based approach, project-based learning, and at the same time, application. Kung anong mga models, instructional models, mga policies, practices, issues on safety, how to use responsible citizenship, diba? Digital citizenship, to be exact, even yung paggamit ng technology. Ngayon, it's either you're going to develop, formulate an instructional or ICT materials na pwede niyong gamitin sa teaching and learning. Parang sort of a research siya. Okay? So, magagamit niyo dito yung mga natutunan ninyo. Even the philosophies, even the theories, how TTL is being used or being applied sa classroom, sa ating classroom. Kasi madaling sabihin, gumagamit ako ng projector or gumagamit ako ng presentation software or let's say PowerPoint or Canva. So, yung bang ginagamit ko, are my students learning from it? Or do I provide them maraming say for example, sa PowerPoint, maraming slides, maraming information na absorb by ng mga students ko by using this kind of technology. Proper bang gamitin ang PowerPoint sa mga rural areas? Diba? Is it applicable paggamit ng music, paggamit ng radio or speaker sa pagtuturo ng math by means of music? So those are the things. So here class, at this point in time, as early as now, though we're a bit late, please think of any ICT-based material that pwede nyong gawin or gamitin sa pagtuturo nyo sa course ninyo, or what I mean sa program ninyo, which is the electrical, sa major ninyo, which is the electrical technology. Sir, pag sinabi pang gagawa kami ng ICT materials, are we going to come up with a prototype, with a mock-up, or instructional device? Hindi po. If you understand TTL1 or Educ 5, we have different types of instructional materials. Whether digital, print or non-print, whether instructional media, whether tech. So, meaning to say, we have different types of materials. Hindi lang po puro prototyping or pure development of an instructional device. Pwedeng gumawa kayo ng module, ng course guide, ng activity worksheets na pwede niyong gamitin sa subject ninyo. And who knows? The reason why I ask you to do this, first one, I want you to learn as early as now how to do research. Kasi yours truly po, I handle the research subject. This will be your training ground how to do your research. Ano bang sinasabi ni Sir Kenji na module? How does it differ from a lesson plan, from a curriculum guide or course guide or or activity worksheets, something like that. Okay? Pag sinabi bang ICT materials, are we required to develop a prototype? Do we need to come up a mock-up? Okay? So you have a lot of ICT materials na pwede nyo i-apply. And second, I would like to emphasize on how you're going to use this pagdating ninyo sa pag-practice teaching. Maybe, in the future, when you have your experiential learning class or subject wherein we will be deployed or to mag-practice teach kayo na magturo ng subject sa electrical, pwede nyo siyang gamitin. Even, let's say, graduate na kayo and you're applying for a teaching position in TLE, lalong-lalo na sa electrical technology, pwede nyo gamitin yung ginawa nyong material. So, marami siyang purpose. At yung gagawin ninyo, hindi naman po yun para sa akin. It's for your own also. Ulitin ko ano? Ang TTL2 is surely put into practice. Meaning to say, this the application, design, production, utilization of your ICT materials for teaching and learning. Okay po. By the way, class, can you still hear me? Is my voice clear?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Yes, po, sir. Yes po, sir.
So, yan po ang content ng ating TTL1. So, take note ha, yung gagawin yung ICT material is sa electrical technology. Kasi yun po ang major ninyo. Hindi po ako magpapagawa ng material na hindi naman align sa course ninyo. In other words, ayoko naman kayong pahirapan. Okay? So, the next one is the course learning outcome. A good description of a course learning outcome is something that is measurable or what the student will acquire or learn after they're through with this course by the end of the semester. Okay? So, one is to demonstrate an in-depth understanding on the phases of designing, preparation, production, integration, utilization, and evaluation of ICT-based technology in education. Don't worry, Sir Kenji will provide you reading materials, a sample video, or other internet source articles, web-based articles na pwede nyong pag-aralan, i-adapt para sa guide ninyo paggawa ng ICT material. So, sa paggawa ng ICT, dadaan tayo sa isang approach na tinatawag natin design thinking. Have you heard about design thinking principle? Class? Honest to goodness, narinig nyo na po ba ito? Have you encountered this term? Hello?
Hindi po po, sir.
Okay. So here, tuturuan ko kayo kung paano gamitin ang design thinking. Ang design thinking kasi, it's a principle na ginagamit na years ago. It's a concept wherein yung instructional materials developer, yung engineers, designers adhere to this. It's a guide for you. It has a five-page siya na pagdadaanan ninyo. The goal is to solve a particular problem and to arrive with a solution to that problem. That's the essence of design thinking. So, but the difference is dadaan kayo sa limang process. Okay? Hindi siya yung kagaya ng halimbawa may problema. Ito yung dapat solusyon. Hindi ganoon. Hindi siya immediate na ito dapat yung solusyon. It needs to undergo a process. Okay? But at least to guide you if in case na maging uh, ma- active na kayo sa academe, nagtuturo na kayo, or nasa isang agency kayo or corporation, pwede niyong i-apply or gamitin itong principle, the design thinking, to arrive with a solution. Maraming mga business professionals, mga nasa industry sectors na napalago, na-improve nila yung system, na-improve nila yung business nila because they apply or adopt this kind of principle. And even sa education, maganda itong gamitin. Kapag pag nasa academe na kayo, you can adapt or apply to this. Second is manifest competence in designing, developing, producing, validating, utilizing, and evaluating effective ICT-based materials for teaching and learning in the context of K-12. Sir, pwede ba kami, sir, gumawa ng ICT materials para gamitin namin sa mga senior high school students or K-12 na kakursa sa K-12 program? Yes, because maybe in the near future, kapag magtuturo na kayo, maybe na-assign kayo sa DepEd, and parehas yung discipline ninyo, pwede nyo siyang magamit. And third is show ethical principles or practices in developing information in community technology ICT-based materials for teaching and learning. Okay? So, yan ang ating course learning outcomes. So, now, I will be presenting you the course outline. Actually, class, in-adapt namin yung Melo. Supposed to be maraming topic siya. Since nasa pandemic tayo, and since, limited na yung time natin. Within the following weeks, May, March is fast approaching na, di ba? And based on our school calendar, second week of March is your midterm exam. So, ang ginawa namin, nila Sir Chan, Sir Nick, we modify the topics para at least makakope up and makahabot tayo sa deadline. So, dito pa lang tayo actually. So, introduction to the course, and ito, it covers 4 or 5 topics, essential topics. First is the planning and designing of ICT-based instructional materials. Here, I'm going to introduce you different models, approaches, or techniques na pwede nyong i-apply para makapag-isip kayo ng isang ICT-based material. Kung saan siya bagaling. Okay? Second is to develop. So here, we are going to present to us ano ba ang development. That's why one of our requirement is a status or progress report. Here, class, I want to train you independent learning. Okay? You're going to learn on your own. Ay, si sir, baka nagapalusot naman. Baka iuga kan magturo. That's not the mentality, class. Kasi yung traditional setup before, di ba? The teacher will meet you, will present the topics, will teach you like this and like that. Okay? Pero, ayun lang po ang role. That's the traditional. Here, sa klasiko po, it's more on constructivist. Diba? It's a principle that we're in. Pag sinabing constructivist teacher ka, you are a facilitator. You are not just a lecturer. Kumbaga, it's a student-centered siya. Na wherein, ang activities or tasks, more of the students. Pero, ang role ng teacher is to facilitate. Like for example, I will providing you handouts, reading materials, lecture notes about a topic. So what you're going to do is to read about it. If you're not satisfied with the topic, you can do your research. You can dig deeper. You can read more. You can watch videos if you want. Diba? To better appreciate the topic and as your guide also sa ginagawa ninyong ICT base. Diba? May consultation naman, don't worry. Sir, tama ba yung ginawa kong module sa first year about circuits or ganyan or series and parallel connection? Yung ba yung topic na yun? Okay, so that's the time that I'll be suggesting how to improve your material and what possible references that you might use to improve the discussion. Okay, sir, tama ba yung prototype na ginawa ko para sa diagram, para sa wiring diagram? So unang-una, yan bang gagamitin mo is did you consider the safety considerations? Baka maganda yung application niya, pero since you will be using 220 volts AC source, syempre it's fatal. It can cause electrocution sa part ng gagan. So pwede tayong mag-usap ng mga ganyang bagay. And aside from that is the product production implementation and utilization of ICT-based instruction materials. Okay? And the last part, ito po yung gagawin nyo. You're going to present to us. Para siyang mini defense, pero hindi naman masyadong formal. You're going to present to us your output. Okay? Na about sa ginawa nyong ICT material. Or if not, sa time allotted sa atin, pwede nyo siya, you can prepare a short video, probably 10 to 15 minutes lang, about your material. So, isend nyo lang sa akin. Ganun lang kasimple. So, yung midterm, eto ha, bonus ko na ito sa inyo. Yung midterm and final requirement ninyo is yung gagawin yung ICT-based material saka ipapresent ninyo. Okay? May dalawang options tayo. Pwedeng ipresent natin siya actual or pwede siyang pre-recorded. Okay? By the way, class, can you follow? Can you still hear me?
Yes po, sir.
Okay. Yes, sir.
So, ganoon lang po kasimple yung ating syllabus. So, these are my requirements, specific requirements. Progress reports of ICT-based IMs. So, after this class, if wala naman kayong date, or wala naman kayong gagawin, think of a possible ICT-based materials. You can message me anytime you want. My lines are always open, almost 24/7. Walang problema. If hindi ko mabasa ngayong gabi, bukas. If I'm available, I can message you right away. Okay? Or if not, gagawa ako ng sa ating classroom kung anong mga topic or gagawin yung ICT-based material. Pwedeng gumawa kayo ng gagawa kayo ng website or gagawa kayo ng mga pwede, you can use the internet, you can use any tools, 'di ba? Just think outside the box. Something that it would be better, something that is new, something na hindi ginagamit ng mga faculty. You can apply gamification in education. When I say gamification, pwede kayong kumap ng games. Yan, mag-kumap ng games, hindi yung Mobile Legends ha, hindi yung COD, hindi yung Valorant, hindi yung ganun. I'm referring to games na related sa electrical technology. Pwedeng an app that can. So, basta kaya niyo. Hindi ko naman kayo pinipilit pag hindi naman kaya. Okay? Unang-una, yung gagawin ninyo, kaya niyo ba? Kaya ba ng oras ninyo? Kaya, because of, I know you have this, marami kayong subjects din that has lots of requirements. So, akin, ganun lang po ang requirement ko. Ganun kasimple. And progress report. So, even yun lang po ang gagawin ninyo, magpo-post po ako ng mga reading materials or lectures. At the same time, may mga quiz din ng konti or activities. Diba? Kagaya ng unang pinagawa ko, some of you are wondering, bakit si Sir Kenji nagpagawa ng teaching credo and kailangan ba namin i-post? So what if sir nakalock yung profile namin sa Facebook? Hindi mo mababasa. Plus, ganito lang yan. Di ba ang subject natin, technology for teaching and learning too? Ang ginawa ninyo is integration of technology. Actually, pag naging teacher na kayo, pag naging faculty na kayo, pwede nyo gamitin to. I don't know if still applicable pa ba ang Facebook or pagdating ng time, obsolete na. Iba na ginagamit na technology. So, my point here is, yung activity ko is may kinalaman sa TTL 2. Second, merong, yung ginawa niyong credo, yung ginawa niyong principle or dogma, or yung point of, ang tawag dito, yung slogan ninyo, yan yung magsisilbing pamantayan ninyo or your guide of why you are here. Why are you taking BTB TED major in electrical technology? What is your purpose? Ano ba? Para makatapos lang? Makatapos lang yung 4-year course and look for a job? Eh, sa ganun ba, madali ba makahanap ng trabaho? Diba? kumbaga, you will finish the bitibit just to work. Pero still, floating ka pa rin. What type of work? I know some of you hate yung teaching. It's common. In my 5 years as an educator here in BU, in Busit, base sa kanilang feedback, they don't want to be a part of educator. Kasi sa totoo lang, sad to say, ang mga mindset ng mga Pilipino, kaba, toxic, this is what I call toxic Filipino culture. Pag sinabing teacher, is mababang klaseng uri ng trabaho. Which it's really dismayed on our part. Diba, as what they say, teaching is a noble profession. Yan pa, another toxic Filipino culture naman. Pag sinabing teacher daw or educator, ito yung mga taga-London, daa. Diba? Pag sinabing taga-London, loan dito, loan doon. mga para-utang. Little they know na ang teacher is doon mababa. Diba? Pero actually, iba sa university, but I'm not discriminating the deaf ed community. But I am proud that we are educators, that we are molders of the youth. We parang kami yung nagiging silbing parang guide, diba? We are like drivers. Na yung mga estudyante namin parang mga, diba, pasahero na ginaguide natin sila sa magandang daan. Parang sort like that. Pero sa Pilipinas kasi ang baba ng tingin ng tao sa educators. Pero di nyo alam kung sino yung magiging presidente ngayon, kung sino yung mga engineers, sila mga doctors, mga lawyers, galing din sa amin, di ba? Kami ang molders ng mga new generation of heroes or somebody who can help to improve the economy, to improve the society, something like that. Okay? Ito yung aside from the progress reports, midterm and final examination, okay, and then terminal report, and yung dinevelop yung ICT-based materials. Okay, so ito yung ating grading system. Yung integrative or progress report, 50%, yung exam natin, 50%, ganun lang kasimple, total, 100%. Sa tentative naman, 20% of progress report, final exam. So, magpe-present kayo ng output ninyo, 40%, and yung e-portfolio ninyo. Okay, so bale, 100% siya lahat. So, midterm, 30, 60, or 33.33%, and tentative, 66.67%, total of 100%. So, yan po ang ating grading system. And ito yung ating mga references na ang iba mahanap sa internet, ang iba e-books in connection to the course. Okay? Ito yung ating mga policies, and then yeah. So ito yung content ng ating syllabus. Okay po? So stop sharing muna natin. So is there any questions or clarifications about our course syllabus? Feel free to ask po, or do you have something to share or react? Class? Hello, are you still there? Hello?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Sige. Let us check. Last time you posted, check ko muna, no? Most of you posted their outputs. And let us see. One of my activity is about, since we have how many minutes, 18 or 20 minutes left, check natin yung ginawa niyong output. By the way, class, wag niyo pong kakalimutan na ito po yung ating classroom. By the way, nakikita po ba?
Yes po, sir.
Thank you. So, ito po yung ating classroom. And based on my naka-enroll sa akin, 24 students ang andito. So, sa aking faculty center po, 26 po ang enrolled sa akin. Please inform him or her na, or include muna siya sa ating group chat. Okay, kindly include her or him sa ating group chat before proceeding sa ating classroom. Okay? Ito po yung ating avenue. This is the only avenue for us to conduct sync meetings. That's why andito po yung ating link. Google Meet link. And yeah. And mga activities po andito po sa ating classroom. Diba? Unang-una po, requirement ko is COR. Madali lang itong gawin. By the way, lahat po ba kayo meron ng COR? Class? Is there anyone here wala pang COR up to now? Hello? Lahat po ba meron? If meron po, can you raise hand icon po? Sige. So, I assume that everyone has the... So, ang gagawin nyo lang po is kindly upload your COR here. Because COR is very important. From the start of the class or from the beginning, the faculty, it's either instructor or professor, is asking you to have with you a hard copy of your COR. Since we are in the pandemic and flexible learning modality is being applied, kailangan po natin ng soft copy lang ng ating COR. Let's say a student who diligently attends to my sync meetings, walang paltos, hindi siya nag-a-absent, she always attends, even sa exams, kompleto niya, she submitted the requirements on time, and even the projects, and able to pass the exams. And here comes the time that I'm going to compute the grades. Later, I found out that that student, wala siyang COR. Meaning to say, all the records, all the things uploaded will be void. Okay? It's very important to have with you a copy of COR because that signifies that you are officially enrolled in my class. Kasi kung wala kang COR, hindi ka po taga-busit. Hindi ka po enrolled sa klase ko. Ganun lang kasimple. Ang gagawin nyo lang is... Hindi naman po abuti ng dalawang oras, isang oras make it. It's in less than a minute. Access the form. By the way, I'll show you. Ito po yung ating form. Diba? Magta-type ka lang ng name, yung COR, yung date, tapos. I repeat, in less than a minute, kaya nyo itong i-accomplish. But I saw, still, ito, 7 pa lang. 7 pang hindi nakakapag-submit. Don't forget also yung flexible learning survey. Because this will be my basis on what strategies should I adopt or use. Let's say, most of my students has problems with internet connection or mahina yung signal sa kanilang area. So definitely, my approach will be hindi ako magpo-conduct ng synchronous meeting on a regular basis. Diba? Kasi our schedule, limited yung oras, hapon pa or paggabi na. Second, thrice a meeting tayo mag-meet. Diba? So, if there is an urgent meeting or something that I would like to announce or may activities tayo or may kailangan kayong i-set natin clear, that's the time that we'll be going to conduct sync meetings. I don't usually resort synchronous meeting regularly. Ito pa, baka magkaroon ng misconceptions. Si Sir Tabi, di man Tabi yan nagka-klase. Di man Tabi yan nag-meet sa muya. I-orient ko kamugirari, ang modality natin is flexible learning. Diba? Yan po ang ina-adapt ng BU. When we say flexible learning, we have two kinds, asynchronous and asynchronous. Hindi naman ibig sabihin na pag nag-meet si Sir Kenji, dahil na nagtatrabaho, dahil na nagkaklase. Pero, si Sir Kenji, maski dahil nag-conduct asynchronous, nagtaok yung mga lectures, nagtaok yung mga handouts, nagtaok yung mga video tutorials, or any materials na kinagamit sa ating TTL2, does it signify na si Sir Kenji hindi gumagawa ng trabaho niya? Diba? Alam nyo, class, even we prepare our materials religiously, we devote much time. Sa totoo lang, ang paggawa, kaya ngayon, may experience ninyo kung ano bang ginagawa ng mga faculty or teacher in preparing ICT-based materials. Not all faculty, especially the senior faculty, are well-versed in technology. And this is what I would like you to emphasize. Please bear in mind, hindi pare-pare yung capacity namin. Ako, hindi naman sa pagmamayabang. I know how to use this technology. I know how to use this technology. But but some of my colleagues find it difficult, especially the senior. Diba? They find it hard to use this kind of technology. Kaya sometimes, liwanagan ng isip. Okay? Ang iba kasi, ang gagaling mag-run. Ang gagaling mag, di ba? Okay, mass promo. Stop the pain. Stop, di ba? Pero hindi naman nagbabasa ng learning material. Sir Kenji, ganyan, ang daming requirements. Ang tanong ba, binasa mo ba yung material? Nakalagay naman doon. You have the options to decide what will be your project. And my projects or tasks, wala naman po siyang binibigay na deadline. Okay? Sana lawakin din ang pag-isip. Okay? Kasi, si Sir Kenji po is a pro student talaga. Because I was once an advisor, at the same time, student coordinator. And I know what you're going through. Pare-pares lang naman tayo. Ang akin lang, maging open kayo sa akin, and open din naman ako sa inyo. Vice versa. It's give and take lang. Hindi yung agad, kada tamili na dagitan, Sir Kenji, ako kasi, I'm being honest with myself. Hindi ako pabebe. I say right, straightforward ako eh. If I see something wrong, I say it in front of your eyes na mali ang ginagawa mo. Hindi ako papamper ha. Hindi ko ugali mag-comfort ng estudyante. Kasi sa level ko pa lang, sabi ko sa inyo, this course, this subject, or any subject, this is your training ground. Kasi you will meet a lot of people with different character and attitude. Kung sa level ko pa lang, medyo nahihirapan ka, mag-isip-isip ka. Kasi sa actual world, sa ibang sitwasyon, may mga boss ka, may mga supervisor ka, manager ka, na may encounter, mas rude, mas sarcastic, magsalita, mas kumbaga. So, that's it. The reason why you are here because you want to learn. Hindi para i-comfort, hindi para i-pamper. And I really hate spoon feeding. Sir, ano pa yung isa sir hindi nagtuturo? Kailangan namin, come on. You have the materials already. You are no longer high school anymore. Diba? This time, iba yung sitwasyon natin. Hindi tayo nasa actual classroom setting. Okay? Isa pa. If you will observe, I posted there sa ating JC, paano ang mag-approach ng teacher. Ito lang ha, hindi ako nagiging maarte ha. Ito lang, kasi may ibang students, akala mo, kung makachat sa teacher, diba? Parang ka-level nila, parang, diba? Ako, totoo ako makipagkarawan, totoo ako makipag-vibes, totoo ka yan. Pero, in the middle of the night, mahapot ka, sir yata binagsak mo ako. Saan ako nagkamali? Come on, sa Google Classroom, sa email mo, mailing mo kung anong mga bagay na day ka pang incomplete. Do I have? Kailangan pa bang elaborate? Kumbaga, sa wrong radio station, kailangan pa bang i-memorize yan? Okay? So, that's it. This is who I am. If you find me na parang, kung sa tingin mo terror ako, kung sa tingin mo stick ako, if you think that I'm not doing my job, I'll send you a dropping form. Bigay ko sa inyo, pilapan ninyo, and yeah. That's it. Amanos tayo. Why would I waste my time for students na hindi naman pala ako vibes or gusto yung subject ko. Diba? You can look for somebody who can teach you TTL too. Diba? Just saying, hindi naman ako galit. Hindi naman ako okay? I'm just stating facts here. For the sake of the teachers also na nagpapakihirap din na gumawa ng lessons and lectures nila and later hindi pa na-appreciate. Okay? Sige. So, class, is there any questions or clarifications about the course syllabus or topics here sa ating classroom? Anyone? Hello? Matakot ba kayo? Class, are you still there?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So,
wala na po, sir.
So, again, kindly accomplish yung preliminary task. Okay lang, wala pa naman siyang deadline. Basta wag niyo lang kakalimutan. And isa pa, don't procrastinate yourself. Yung term is procrastination. Pag sinabi yung procrastination, kung pwede mo man lang palang gibuon mo niyan, yata ipapaabuton mo pa kay perang aldaw, kay perang bulan, masabi ka mo, sir, di ba, I'm tired, I'm exhausted. Diba? Yung vacant time, anong ginawa mo? Di ba? So, bakit ibubukas mo pa? Pwede mo naman pala gawin ngayon. So, what I also want to emphasize here sa course na to, hindi lang sa course na to, ano, even sa rest of the subjects na pinag-aaralan ninyo, keyword class, time management. Okay? If alam mong nahihirapan ka, bakit ka pa nag-take? Ganun lang kasimple. Life is so short. Diba? If alam mo naman pala na ayaw mo na nahihirapan sa klasiko or na sa ibang subject, bakit ka pa nag-enroll? Siyempre, you want to learn, right? Siyempre, gusto ko sir matuto. Gusto mo nga matuto. Pero ang problema naman is ang dami mong hanash. Ang dami mong reklamo sa buhay. I-compare mo yung mga batang nasa labas, batang nasa, di ba, nasa lansangan na gusto din mag-aral. Di ba? Iba-ibang sitwasyon natin. Iba-ibang sitwasyon. Pero you're still blessed. Nandito kayo sa BU. Andito kayo. Ay, ayoko na mag-aral sa BU kasi nahirapan ako. Kahit saan kang school, pare-pares ng sitwasyon natin. Ito lang. I respect people who are experiencing mental health issues or problems or let's say depression. Kasi, been there. I've been there. If someone is suffering or experiencing this problem, naiintindihan ko po. Kasi even as faculty, tao din kami. Diba? Ang importante lang is magsabi ka sa amin, sir, I find it hard with your subject. What can I do? Just be open. Okay? Let's develop harmonized or good communication or a rapport between us. Okay? That's the key. As another key also is communication. Kasi if you say okay, is there any question? None. Tapos mamaya magcha-chat. Sir, paano ba 'to? Okay lang 'yan. I will entertain you. So just be true to yourself. If you find this subject hard or ayaw mo lang, tapos magra-run ka lang sa social media, para kay pa. Diba? Just saying, okay? Kasi I have to depend also that may colleagues or faculty na parang binabash or ng mga ibang students. I'm not referring to you, ha? I'm not saying it as a general or as a whole. That there are students na, yes sir, galing mo magturo, later on magpo-post sa social media, si sir nga yun, weak nga yun, sir nga yun, hindi marunong gumamit. Come on, guys. Okay? So, before we end our session, Tabi, or meeting, I'll discuss another activity po next meeting. Ano? Since limited lang yung time natin, can I ask for a photo documentation as our basis that we conduct classes? Can you please turn on your camera?
Yes po, sir.
Thank you. Sige po, ano? While waiting po, is there any questions po, clarifications about the course? About the subject? If nahiya po kayo, just message me ano. Just message me lang po if you have questions or clarifications. Okay. 1, 2, 3, smile and happy Hearts Day. Thank you everyone. Good evening.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you po.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Bye. Thank you, sir. Thank you po.
Sige po.
Thank you, sir.
Sige.
Thank you po, sir.
Zombie apocalypse.